From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Bahamas Petroleum Company announced yesterday that it did not find commercial volumes of oil after drilling a well off of Andrus. News of the failure caused BPC's stock to take a more than 60% hit yesterday, knocking millions off the value of the company. In a statement, the company said that some oil was encountered as indicated from logging while drilling, gas chromatography, and mud logs. Drilling has now ceased, the well having reached a depth of approximately 3,900 meters without incident, and the well will now be permanently plugged and abandoned, the company said. The company added that its operational activity in the near term will now focus on work in Trinidad and Tobago and Suriname. BPC's drilling began on December 20th, 2020, and ended on Sunday, with the company completing its exercise within its projected 45 to 60 days window. A Royal Bahamas Defense Force officer accused of raping a colleague has been relieved of his duties pending a police investigation into the allegations, the RBDF confirmed yesterday. In a press statement, the RBDF said the incident took place in Matthewtown, Inagua. RBDF officials also said the alleged victim has already been seen by a local doctor in the community and is expected to receive counseling. Meanwhile, the alleged perpetrator has since been placed into police custody. Police in the capital are investigating three new homicides, the latest incident happening last night after 11 p.m. when police received reports of a shooting incident that occurred on Lincoln Boulevard in the vicinity of Homestead Avenue. On arrival of the first responding officers, they met a male suffering from apparent gunshot wounds to the face. Emergency medical services were summoned. The victim was transported to hospital, where he later died as a result of his injuries. Meanwhile, police are also investigating an incident which occurred off of Cowpen Road shortly after 5 p.m. yesterday. A man's body was found unresponsive lying on the ground. The final incident involved a man who died in hospital on Sunday after being stabbed. The government is exploring whether to adopt so-called COVID-19 vaccine passports in a bid to make two-way travel involving the Bahamas easier. Tourism Minister Dionisio de Aguilar told the Tribune. He said yesterday that he has asked officials to study whether this nation should follow other countries in developing documents and protocols that would enable tourists and Bahamians to prove they have been vaccinated against the potentially fatal virus. Such a regime, if adopted, could facilitate the free flow of travel to and from the Bahamas by both locals and residents, once global vaccination programs achieve critical mass, a development that appears to be some months off. Vaccine passports showing a person has been inoculated could also dramatically reduce the need for pre-arrival and in-country COVID-19 testing. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, Donald Trump's second impeachment trial is starting, an undertaking like no other in U.S. history. The defeated former president stands charged by the House with inciting the deadly mob attack on the Capitol to overturn the election in what prosecutors argue is the most grievous constitutional crime. Trump's lawyers are insisting as the Senate trial opens today that he is not guilty of the sole charge of incitement of insurrection, his fiery words just a figure of speech as he encouraged a rally crowd to fight like hell for his presidency. The Capitol siege on January 6th stunned the world as rioters stormed the building to try to stop the certification of President-elect Joe Biden's victory. Five people died. The coronavirus most likely appeared in humans after jumping from an animal, a team of international and Chinese scientists looking for the origins of COVID-19 said today, dismissing as unlikely an alternate theory that the virus leaked from a Chinese lab. A closely watched visit by World Health Organization experts to Wuhan, the Chinese city where the first coronavirus cases were discovered, did not dramatically change the current understanding of the early days of the pandemic, said Peter Ben Emberick, the leader of the WHO mission. But it did add details to the story, he said at a news conference as the group wrapped up a nearly four-week visit to that city. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. Ridging continues to dominate the weather pattern across the islands through tonight. Beachgoers in the central and southeast Bahamas should exercise caution due to the risk of rip currents along eastern shorelines. For all areas, it'll be mostly sunny, very warm and humid, becoming mostly fair and warm tonight. Small craft caution is in effect for the central and southeast Bahamas. Winds light and variable at 10 knots or less this afternoon, becoming east east to southeast at 10 to 15 knots tonight in the northwest Bahamas, east to southeast at 15 to 20 knots with higher gusts in the central and southeast Bahamas. Seas 3 feet or less this afternoon, building 2 to 4 feet tonight in the northwest Bahamas, 4 to 6 feet in the central and southeast Bahamas. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 88 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 72. The sun will set this afternoon at 5:58 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:47. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.